Right, here we go, guys. We drop into episode 3 in our DMs because we've got some scouting reports come back. Let's have a look what the boys have managed to find out there. So we've got Wiley out in England. He's obviously been out there for a while, 6 months in fact, because Max Ford has been on this list since the beginning. And his potential has not dropped away, so he is still an option for us to pick up. We then got Dominic Rogers starting to drop away potential-wise, but I will still monitor him just because he's already been on this report for 3 months. Elijah Walters, again, he's dropped off completely, so we will reject him. He has got a decent value, though, so his overall actually might be quite high. It's just that he's got no potential. I'll keep him here for now, and we might potentially think about signing him at the end of the report and then maybe selling him to make some money going into next season. Jackson Hale is here with a 72 to 80 potential. Not great, to be honest, but again, we'll keep him around on the report, as Jasper White is very similar. Jay Anderson, 63 to 81. We've then got Ezra Haynes, 48 to 60 and at 72 to 92 potential, worth 190,000. So his overall value means that his overall isn't going to come out high. He's probably in the lower range of his overall, but the potential is interesting, so he's definitely staying on this report. We then got a new one added to the list, is Declan Daniels, 61 to 83 potential, probably not going to make the cut, especially at 15, so we might as well remove him now. Blake Mitchell, definitely not making the cut, potential 56 to 74. Peter Wade, 63 to 87. His value suggests that his overall could be pretty good, so we'll keep him around on this report. And then we've got Elijah Evans, 42 to 56, 60 to 82. Again, not fantastic, but we'll continue to monitor his progress going forward. Moving on to Jamie Glover, who is in Wales looking for somebody. Lloyd Howell, definitely not going to make the cut. And then we've got Tom Palmer, 15 years of age. So we'll probably leave him on the report until the 3 months are up, and hope he doesn't get stolen by Wrexham in the meantime. He's worth £375,000 at this point, so his overall is probably going to be somewhere in the mid to high 50s, and that potentially is very good. So let's see what happens when we come back here in a month's time. And then last but not least, we've got Jordan Wright, who's up in Scotland with Ian Robertson, a 15-year-old, 66 to 88 potential, only worth 150k, so his overall won't be particularly high. And then we've got Duncan Robertson, potential way too low, so we'll reject him and hopefully find something else in Scotland next time round. Whilst we're here, let's have a look at the actual youth academy itself. Bowman can be converted to a cam now, 62 overall. He jumps by one to a 63. Remember, he's only 15 though, so we can't promote him yet, and we are seriously interested in how he progresses over the course of the rest of this season, looking into the start of next. It doesn't look like we've seen any kind of upgrades aside from Bowman this month, but nonetheless, the youth academy is looking pretty good at the moment. Right, here we go then. The first game of the episode is Notts County versus MK Dons. Well, that's great work by Galloway, but he can't quite keep it in. Great challenge. It's just that final pass, trying to find a gap in the defence. He's almost proving impossible. Ball out wide here to Gilby. McIntyre trying to be his shadow though and prevent him getting that ball into the box. Forces him to shift it back here to Harvey. Sends it inside. Williams. Snapshot. Great save by Scott. Pushes that up and over the bar. Roy will take the corner for MK Dons. Down the left hand side, cuts back, comes inside to Gilby, across to Williams. Dennis trying to find the space, they do wriggle their way through, but Scott is able to push the effort away. More of the same in this second half, but let's see if we can actually create a chance. I don't believe, aside from a long range effort from Carter, that we actually had anything in that first half to offer from an offensive point of view. Very good work by Galloway. Right, we'll pitch one into the middle. Oh, that's our first real attempt on goal. Is the referee? Oh, it's an offside. Yeah, just. Unlucky there from Fletcher. I mean, it didn't convert it anyway, but it was a good effort. The first one that we've really had so far in this game. And inside for Carter. One more up to Galloway. It's wide space out wide here for McCarthy. Come back inside for Haynes. Across to the cannon. Looking for space here. He's found Wang. He knocks it back inside. And Fletcher with a quick snapshot from sort of 16 yards. Nearly puts us in the lead here. McIntyre gets back into shape. McGee, fantastic work there by McGee to block the effort as the opposition came forward. And the corner, Galloway can't quite wriggle his way through. Fletcher can't wriggle his way through either. What a tackle. What a tackle. He's putting his body on the line. Warner. Oh, he can't feed his teammate. And there we have it, a 0-0. Not the most entertaining performance in terms of shots on target, but nonetheless, it is another point on the board for Notts County in a hard-fought game. Okay, so another five-man defence here in our second game of the episode against Newport County. They're playing in a 5-3-2 holding and they offer standard tactical vision with McLaughlin and Charlesley, their key attacking players. Last five matches, three wins, a draw and a loss, the last one being the loss. And it looks like Morris got sent off in that game, so hopefully we can use that to our advantage going forward in this one. Overlapping run here from Wright. Back to McCarthy. One more to Carter, who decides to pull the trigger. Townsend's up to that challenge. Haynes. Quang. Paul Galloway pulls the trigger and then Haynes follows it up with an effort from long range. Doesn't manage to find the target though. Find him. Fletcher. Yes, boys! Great link-up play between the two strikers there to find the opening. And Fletcher bags from 18 yards out. Right, he nestles one right into the bottom left-hand corner. Keeper's got no chance. Well up by the defence there. And Galloway's out here, isolated on his own, waiting for some support. It turns up. Fletcher's waiting for that overlapping run. But McIntyre can't quite get a toe on it. We'll now have to sprint back to get back into shape. Carter taking one for the team, but the ref lets it carry on. Good block. And McGee, as usual, is back there to help out. McCarthy off to Fletcher. We've got an overlap here. We can't find it because he sends it to Haynes instead for some reason. Great save by Scott. His defence did well in front of him, but he still had to make the save. Bogle on the score sheet. Not good defending there from Notts County. Just couldn't just find the right player. As usual, the shifting is a terrible, terrible thing in this game. Gee! With the header as he's falling backwards. The captain gets himself on the score sheet to make it 2-0. Great stuff from Notts County on the road here. Really good corner, and McGee, moving away from the target, still manages to get a good header on it and up and over the keeper. Bang. Yes! Get in. That is a lovely piece of play. Catching the opposition out. And Huang turns it home. Deftest of touches there from Huang to score. And make it 3-1. Kind of slotting into that left back position. He's gone upfield. Good interchange play. Pineda now manages to wriggle his way through. Sends it across the box, and Huang with his second of the game. And we make it 4-1 here on the road. It's turning into quite the victory. Pick them apart. They tried to push up and play an offside, but Pineda kept control of the ball rather than sending it to a teammate, and just was the space was opened up for him. Sends it square across the box, and Huang's there to pick up the pieces. 4-1. Fantastic victory there for the boys on the road. Another 3 points in the bag. And yes, I know we were playing 20th position in the league, but that is a very, very good result for us. Right then, here we go. Another home fixture here at Meadow Lane against Swindon Town this time, who are playing in a 5-2-1-2 formation. Let's see if we can get another result on the board, having picked up the 3 points last time out. Fletcher. McCarthy brings this away, and he looks upfield to find Galloway. He's managed to get in behind, and he slots it home just 7 minutes into this game, and we've already managed to find a goal. Galloway on the score sheet this time, breaking away when the team had already got a free kick against us. Great in transition to get that ball upfield. Galloway just heads and shoulders above the opposition there. Slides it past the keeper. And it's 1-0 to County. Excellent work again. Unable to hold that ball up, and Swindon in the transition here looking to find an opening, and they do. 10 minutes after hours, They've managed to get themselves on the score sheet. A bit of loose defending, having lost possession in the midfield. Banks may be at fault there. McGee doesn't get across either. Scott should really be doing it better at his near post. 1-1. Every time at the near post. 2-1 down now, having taken the lead. Swindon with a swing in their step, managing to unlock our defence twice in quick succession. Both near post finishes as well. Side for Swindon, cuts back inside and then goes back down the line, cuts it back and get the shot away. This time at the near post though, Scott's got it covered. Oh, he's walking round us, and it's their third. Young this time on the score sheet. It's always the defensive errors that cost us. When players get dragged out of position. Oh, those ball rolls. Devastating. And a good finish into the bottom corner. 3-1. Here to Hutton, back inside to Kinsella. That is awesome from Carney. To Galloway, he'll stretch the defence open here. Gone away from him, so he'll go all the way and sticks it in at the near post. And it's a brace for Galloway. Great finish there by the youngster. Didn't put the pressure on him and he just continued his run. Lovely little left-footed finish to the near post. And Bran can't stop that one. 3-2. And this game is far from dead and buried. Into position. Oh, he's done fantastic again. Garfield run this. It's Galloway. Checks back inside, sends it up to Fletcher. Little nod on from Haynes. Round the corner for Carter. Through the gap. Hat trick. Yes, Galloway. Get in. Awesome stuff from the striker. A hat trick in this game and he's put us back in contention. Point on the board and it could end up with three. Let's go. It's a great finish. Even if he did get clattered by the goalkeeper in the end.
Thank you.
Fletcher round the corner and it's our man again. Galloway trying for the fourth, just under pressure from the defender, couldn't wriggle away from him too easily and he misses the target this time. Piece of possessional play here. Galloway shifts back inside, why not? Oh, and he clatters the bar. What an effort there from Galloway. Go on, McGee. How has that not made its way into the net? Patience here. McCarthy wait for the overlap. Back McIntyre. Sticks it in. Galloway's going to get on the end of it. Oh, and Brand with a brilliant save to keep his team in it. McCarthy floats one in. McGee! It's surely the winner. The captain sticking his head on one. The fans are going mental, and why wouldn't you? Even Big Sam's getting involved. Absolute limbs. I mean, it's the obvious tactic. McGee is such a physical presence when he's up there in the box. He's got two to beat. He beats both of them to the ball and gets himself on the score sheet. And hopefully, that is the winner. Swindon trying to find an opening. Hutton into shade. Pulls the trigger to go past, but he can't get past Scott. And it's big hoof time. Can we get another? No, is the answer to that question. But we don't need one. A 4-3 victory, an absolute thriller. And Galloway goes to get himself the match ball. 6 attempts, 3 goals. Fantastic performance from Shane Galloway in that one. It's basically Shane Galloway's world at the moment. And we are just living in it. Here we go then, Walsall it is at the Banksy Stadium as we have to draft in some additional support. We've got a new centre-back on the books here, and as you can see is this man here, Ball, as we've got a bit of fatigue in the squad and need to deal with that. Riley out wide for Walsall, puts it back inside to Tierney. And he cuts it back, and there's the first. Knowles on the score sheet for Walsall. Cut through us like a hot knife through butter. Very, very poor. Considering the way we've been playing as of late, that was not a good piece of play, but it's Ball that's caught out of position. The new player that's been drafted in. Scott, fortunately, not able to come to the rescue on this occasion. McIntyre commits, can't get the tackle in, cuts back, and there's the second. Some more ropey defending as Walsall cut through us like we're not even there. It's that cut back. We've got to learn how to defend against that with these players, because that is what is causing us so many troubles. Great tackle, McCarthy. Can't get the ball away from him though. Oh, and it's the third. Jeez. 30 minutes in and 3-0 down. This could end up being a cricket score if we're not careful. Once again, Walsall just quicker to the ball. It's like our guys are moving through sludge. Scott sends it upfield. McIntyre into the middle. Carter off to Haynes. We'll have it back. Galloway pulls the trigger. Wide of the target. Hat-trick hero last time out. Can't get us back underway. Early doors in the second half, unfortunately. Oh, and Galloway, as it's turned off the line. Bombardment at the moment. McGee, can't get up. Fletcher somehow gets the ball back into the possession of our man. Pineda. There's his look from distance, but nothing going. Great tackle, Pineda. He keeps the ball up, though. Oh, come on. 3-0 loss. Much better in the second half, but Walsall had already done all the damage in the first half. That's 3 points we could well have done without losing if we're going to try and chase down Forest Green and try and maintain that position in the playoffs positions, to be honest. Right, here we go. McGee is away on international duty, so that does leave us with a bit of a void in the middle of defence, but hopefully the boys coming in will be able to cope without his presence. And just as Morecambe come in and flash one past the post, and Wright can't seem to get back on him. Oh, what a challenge. Down the line, inside for Haynes. Go on then, Fletcher. Man out wide. Send him into the box. Great save. And we can't collect the rebound. Slew. That was a very good opportunity for the opposition there, but he hasn't been able to convert it. Well wide. Haynes down the line for Fletcher, who comes inside with a nice ball roll. Lays it into Galloway, and Galloway with the effort. Took a very good save from their keeper. Now McGee. But can we still do well from a corner? Carney up for this one. And he gets it goalward, but without the power on it. 0-0 going into the break. Go Fletch. That's great work by Galloway and Fletcher. Unfortunately, Galloway can't get there. And I feel he might be getting it. No! It's not worth a red referee. And now we have to do it with 10 men. I mean, yeah, it was impetuous, but was it a red card? Well, we escaped one there. Well, a bit of a roll of the dice here from Big Sam. Oh, that's a terrible piece of play. Not have deserved that. Oh, last ditch tackle. Oh, Scott has saved our bacon there. Don't tell me the referee's given something. Is he given the penalty? No way. No way. That is ridiculous. Oh, we went the right way. Maya has put the nail in our coffin. That is heartbreaking. We played so well in that game. Having lost Galloway to a red card as well. I don't think it was a penalty. And Scott nearly saved it. And that will be the last kick of this game. There's no two ways about it. Catch the keeper out. Was there any real shot? Trying to get a goal, and we have unfortunately lost 3 points here. I don't think that was a penalty. Very unfortunate. Very, very unfortunate. Well, that was a gut-wrenching finish to the episode with a loss there on the board against Morecambe. We still sit in ninth place though. We're only 3 points behind Tranmere Rovers and do have a game in hand over them, so potentially could sneak ahead. Having said that though, Salford also have a game in hand. I think that third automatic promotion place is now kind of out of reach. We're 12 points short of Forest Green now. We haven't really got enough games to overhaul them at this stage. So we are now realistically looking to try to get into the playoffs. As to be said, there were some great performances during the course of this episode with a hat-trick from Galloway, but then he got himself sent off in that last game against Morecambe. And that was really the difference between the two teams. Just that extra man on the field made such a difference in terms of the stamina levels. This crop of players are doing very, very well though. Some really good characters emerging. And many of them, I think, will be here for a very long time in this career mode series. Hope you've enjoyed this episode. If you have, don't forget to slap a like on it. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. And I will see you next time.